There's a new Florida Republican who is facing accusations, not like ethics complaints necessarily, something more sinister, accusations of being a witch. We're here talking about Anna Paulina Luna. You can see right here in the official portrait. Although bear in mind, you know, for her fans, that's not how they want to picture her. They want to see her with guns, of course. You can see in this picture, that's how they act. That's the true avatar of their representative. Like, can you get elected these days without having, now you can't just have an assault rifle. That's weak. You have to go akimbo with assault rifles. I don't understand it. My concerns based on that photo, I have many. Witchcraft, not at the top of the list, I'll say. But anyway, she is facing these accusations and is responding legally against them. So a letter, I'm gonna jump ahead to graphic 9, a letter obtained by the Daily Beast reveals that the Florida Republican retained the high-powered law firm Holland and Knight to go after a would-be rival who leveled a series of outlandish allegations against Luna on the Bubba the Love Sponge radio show in the fall. That show is apparently still on. I thought that was a relic of like Tucker Carlson's days of saying incredibly racist and misogynistic things back in the day. No, it's still on. Anyway, the letter demands that Matt Tito, who's a friend of Roger Stone, which is all you need to know about him, mulled challenging Luna in a primary, now needs to apologize on videos for his accusations, which include other claims other than just witchcraft, including that she was fired from a job and that she had some sort of sexual relationship with Representative Matt Gaetz. Luna describes herself as a devoted Christian. I mean, she was elected as a Republican. What else would she be? Tito isn't backing down. He says, I didn't wake up one morning when I was going on the Bubba the Love Sponge show and say, I'm gonna pull a bunch of stuff out of my ass and talk about it. You may not have woken up and said that, but that is what you did. That's exactly what you did. Anna Paulina Luna is a Republican. She's a MAGA person. She, I believe, was endorsed by Donald Trump. I'm sure she's gonna end up being terrible, but not because of hexes, not because of jinxes, not because of fiendish brews. I don't think that's why she's gonna end up being a bad representative. JR, what do you think?
Isn't this weird how this always comes to this? These women that are politicians, representatives in this particular case, whether they're Republican or not. In fact, I think it happens more to Democratic women. But you're getting challenged over this whole thing and then you have your guns out. It still always goes back. I want you guys to compare the potential pictures that are taken, because all these guys do it, as you said. If there's a Republican guy who's holding two guns, do you think his midriff is out? You think he's wearing a tank top? You think he's showing skin? Do you think he has to have his hair perfectly placed and styled? This is the look that they're looking for a representative to legislate for the people. If it's a woman, she's got to be showing the sexual nature of her with these guns. There's this weird mix of, sure, oh, she's so sexy and there's guns. Why? What does this have to do with anything? They want to talk about go ahead.
The guns are the only part of it that bother me. I don't care. Like, I mean, Paul Ryan loved to show off his arms or whatever. Certainly, didn't Mitt Romney pose when he was younger? There are other Republicans that try to like, look, I think a lot of them are 90 years old. They can't necessarily produce a photo like that. So I don't have as much of a problem with that. It's just the need to constantly show yourself to be like the rebirth of Rambo or something.
Yeah, but you have to, but with women, they have to, for some reason, look like this when they do it. Half of their motivation is, oh man, I like the way she looks. Why does it have to anything to do with it? You know, it's if that's your guns, that's your guns. Why does this have to mix? It's just this weird thing that we've come to accept. And I think that's part of their basis for why they do stuff like this. But then it invites this type of other stuff. Look, she's a witch, she's that. This stuff doesn't happen to male politicians. It just doesn't.
That's true.
That's just the way that their approach comes, and you buy into it more and you play in that same character when you do stuff like this. So, I mean, yeah, it shouldn't happen to her, but bro, you know who you're working with.
Yeah. Yeah, I've never heard like, Matt Gaetz is a warlock. No one's ever made that claim.
Have you seen Matt Gaetz's hairy stomach while posing with guns before?
I don't want to. Although I hear he dabbles in necromancy. You're right. That is definitely something that only goes at female candidates. By the way, I am reading of Matt Gaetz that as we speak, as we're recording this, he's leading a huddle with almost 20 representatives and he's gesticulating with great force. So he's up to something. Is it sorcery? I don't know. Stay tuned to find out.
For more political news, breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.